We're talking about powerful and practical prayers. And I want to encourage you that you can pray powerful and practical prayers. So today I want to add something more to your prayer arsenal. And it's something that sometimes people think is quite heavy, but actually I would like to make it easy for you today. And it's the whole aspect of intercessory prayer. So let's start by just looking, what does the word intercession mean? And it's simply this. It's the action of intervening on behalf of another. I want to repeat that. It's the action of intervening on behalf of another. So when your little brother stole some cookies out of the cookie jar and he was about to get a hiding, and you would actually kind of step in and say, no, but it was not really him, and I did it just to save your little brother. You would be interceding on behalf of your little brother with your parents. That's what it's about. So here's the deal. God loves intercessory prayer. Maybe one of the simple reasons is because it means we're not just all selfishly focused on I, me and myself and my needs and what I want, but we actually think of others and their needs, and we intercede for them with God. And in the Bible, there's lots of occasions where we pick up where this happened. But I would like to encourage you to know this, and maybe this is the core of this little message today, is that when you intercede beyond yourself for situations and people, God releases something powerful through those prayers. And you'll see it in a moment's time. I want to use one example from the Bible of such intercession. And it's from Job, the life of Job, an ancient believer who had a place where he was just in a bad spot. Things went wrong in his life. He lost his health. He lost a lot of stuff. He lost family members. And then he had a bunch of friends that actually gave him bogus advice, all in the name of God. And in fact, it was not the best advice. But at the end of the story of Job, right at the end, Job 42 verse 10, you pick up on this astonishing verse, and it says this: and the Lord restored what Job had lost, with these little very important qualifications, when he prayed for his friends. Isn't that amazing? Now, I want to say to you this, just that God wants us to intercede, not only for our friends, but even for those who are maybe not so much our friends anymore. It's very important that we intercede for both friends and enemies, or those that have used us or abused us even. And in Matthew 5 verse 44, those are exactly the words that Jesus used. He says, you must pray for those who spitefully use and persecute you. Wow. So please know this. If you see this and you take it and you make it part of your prayer arsenal, that I will intercede for people, both my friends and those that are maybe my enemies even, it releases something in your life. So what does it release? Well, it seems that with that, God actually steps in and turns the tide and turns open the taps of blessing and favor in our lives through intercessory prayer. It's a byproduct. So back to Job 42 verse 10, it reads like this at the end of that verse: and God gave Job twice as much as he had before. Wow. Now, I'm not propagating just this a kind of a cheap recipe for doubling everything you've got. But all I know is that God is into the business of restoration and blessing and favor, and to a degree that we maybe can't even think about. But this is for you. And if you will engage with intercessory prayer beyond your feelings and emotions, and pray for your friends, pray for your enemies, pray God's blessing on them, pray God's covering and mercy on their lives, something of God's favor and blessing and restorative power will be released in your life. So again, it's an awesome prayer tool, intercessory prayer. I would like to pray for you that you will see the fruit of intercessory prayer. So a simple prayer. Lord, I pray for everyone watching this, that they will lock into intercessory prayer, praying for their friends and their enemies. God's blessing, God's undeserved mercy and grace upon their lives. And that then, Lord, you will release in them and through them an amazing power for restoration. And I pray this with faith in your ability, Lord. Amen.